Welcome back to the fifth and final round for the Modern 2K. And this round we have Dadden again on Naya Burn against Philip on Blue Green Infect. Should be a terrible matchup for Philip, but we'll see how it goes. And it's going to be like title dependent most of the time. Whoever goes first is always going to be advantage in my opinion.
Yeah, they'll most likely have the most mana to do things.
Also, like, I think Philip's in a slightly better position against Dan's burn than against normal burn, because no Eidolon to like really do
to
in his
really
day.
Punish the cheap spells that are in his deck.
And like players are dissolving their draws, so we'll switch there.
I'm curious to see how this Infect deck performs, you know, after the banning of the Gitaxian Probe.
I'm gonna be honest with you, it hasn't looked too overpowering on camera so far. No offense to Philip, he's been piloting okay. Yeah. There was a couple of times we didn't
like
pilot it very well.
Philip's going for a mulligan there.
Yep.
Not just throwing extra cards for fun.
And I believe Dadden's going first, because I think he won the title. And he has Swift Spear in his opening hand, along with double Toxic Command, Bodice Charm.
Looks like he's got a decent start.
I mean,
he just needs to find a green source to get that Atarkus Command online.
Yep. And Philip mulled, probably not enough creatures. Mulled to six. Looks like a Blighted Agent.
Seems that Philip's decided to keep.
I believe it's Glistener Elf, land, Blighted Agent. Can't see any other spells because of Blair. Could be a Mitre Vault closer.
It looks like he's seeing a Mite on the top for the Scry.
I mean, he could want it, but
it depends on the number of threats he has. I mean, I'm sure
pretty sure I saw Glistener Elf and Blighted Agent, so threat wise, it's pretty good. And actually, Philip on the play. Deciding whether or not he wants to play Glistener Elf tonight.
I think he's priced into just going for it here.
Yep.
I mean, his deck's pretty linear. If he had the Dork, he'd obviously lead on that. So that he could untap plays, you know, Infect threat, and have potential protection backup.
Well, without Gitaxian Chrome in the meta, it's kind of hard to turn 2 kill now. So Dan can safely just source the attack, yeah. Philip down to 16. We'll switch to Battlefield View. And now we see more than likely a big swing. Oh.
Well, it depends if does Philip have a second green source. So
I think
he's
the Wingswept Ethan Hand.
I know he sacrificed one to fetch a Pleading Pool.
But I think there's another one. We'll take a look at the hands so you guys can see. I think the far left is a Wingswept Ethan.
Possibly.
I mean, it matches the art.
Is that a Becoming Mince in his hand?
It is a Becoming Mince, but it's unlikely you'll be able to cast it this turn. If he had exactly like Mutagenic Growth. Mutagenic Growth, then it's fine. I'm going to assume it is a Windswept Heath and he's just deciding to play the Manland, so Manland has haste basically for next turn. Well, not haste, but can attack the next turn.
Sure. Also, if he deploys the Blighted Agent this turn, he'll have his choice of Infect Leeches to try and win the game with.
And Dan takes one. I don't think there's going to be an additional. Yeah, just the one Infect there.
Yeah.
Then I'm going to shock himself. 18. Hopefully has an answer for one of the Infect targets. Yeah, Searing Blaze.
That is pretty good that year.
Philip takes 3, down to 13. Attacks for 2, down to 11. And
so does that Blighted Agent in the yard allow Philip to go for the Becoming Mince win this turn?
Yes. It becomes exactly lethal at this point.
So he goes...
Because he's going to go Sack a Land, Exit Card in Yard. Then Might of Ultosa, +4/+4,
making
Exit
it
Card
a
in
five,
Yard.
Five.
And then he's going to be able to cast the
so
you
have to
for
use
two.
The man land for mana.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, so much for Infect slowing down.
Hey, well, it's turn 3 when as opposed to turn 2. It was very easy as a turn 2 with Taxifurban format. Because he could have, like, Danim stepped out there basically on the play turn to die.
That could have been the end of the game with the Glisten Elf, sure.
Yeah. Whereas, like, now it's Glisten Elf start will get you a turn 3 win, which is what.
It's
like,
still decent,
it's
considering
still good,
you know,
but
Modern was touted as the turn 4 format.
It's a good point, but at the same time, you have to remember this draw was pretty good for Philip, if you think about it. I mean, he used every card except one in his hand.
Yeah. Well, I mean, they normally do when it comes to the early turn wins.
But they get the Taxian Probe, which lets them filter cards.
Cycle through, yeah.
So, okay, that's game one to Philip. Not much of a game, really. It's always going to be a blistering fast match in this type of game.
Yes.
So, we'll talk about...
Yeah, let's see what they might be doing out of the sideboard.
Well, look at Danim first, obviously. Deflecting Palm. One of my favorites against Infect. Why? It doesn't deal Infect damage, but it stops the Alpha Strike.
Yeah, you could cobble together two, if not three, for one, just for the low class of two mana and one card.
Yeah. And the next card I'd like to bring in is Pyroclasm, because A, gets it on Spellskite, which Infect's definitely bringing in. B, wipes
definitely.
The entire board.
Yeah. I think we could see quite a shift in what Darren's going to be playing. It's going to look more like a low to the ground control deck. I could see him bringing in the Kosali Pride Mage as well. You know, it could threaten to keep a Ink Moth at bay, check a Spellskite, and attack, because, you know, Philip's not really going to be interested in blocking.
The other cards I'd like Darren to side out are probably like Tox Command and Lightning Helix. Yes, they make racing really good, but
it's not a conventional race that we're dealing with here.
It's just we need to kill them without dying to Infect, which means we need to play a control game.
Exactly.
Like, a lot of the time, you need to understand that with Burn, you have to analyze, if you're slower than them, you have to play the control game. If you're faster than them, you have to just race.
Yeah. I'm not too keen on the Voice of Resurgence in this matchup.
Me neither, but there's not enough for Darren to bring in. Maybe you could say, okay, if I'm not going to leave in Voice, then I'll leave some number of Helixes in, because they still target creatures.
Yeah, but I can see at least... So if he brings in the three Deflecting Palms... The two Pyroclasms, Path to Exile's not unwelcome in this matchup.
And the Kosali Pride Mage, that's a total of
eight cards,
and he's taking out four Helixes and four Toxicomon, which is eight cards.
So do you think there's more value in him keeping the Voices in because it's a recurring source of damage?
Yes, I think Voice of Resurgence is a really hard card for Philip to answer, because if Darren goes Burn Spell in my turn, and Philip goes Protection Spell, he just gets a big guy.
It definitely will pound on the pressure.
Whereas, we'll look at Philip's sideboard. If I'm Philip, I'm interested in bringing in something like Spell
Wild
Pierce
Defiance,
and Wild Defiance.
All day, every day. Spell Pierce.
I'm not sure about this member. I think I would, because my opponent... Oh, okay. I know Darren's list. That is why I would bring in this member. If I'm Philip, I wouldn't bring in this member against Burn. Not a chance.
I see there's an interesting one of them there, Carrion Call.
Yep. And Carrion Call's deal with, like, Jund decks, really. I don't know if it's going to be too relevant in this match, because you don't want to see yourself getting to 4 mana when you're on Infect side of the field.
And I see there's only one copy of Spellskite in Philip's 75.
Yeah, it's surprising. He used to be playing 2 mainboard, whereas now it's just one. Probably so the card's gotten a bit worse. And
I think the stock would have gone up with the, you know, the recent pending of Fatal Push.
That's a good point.
I mean, sure, it's a hard removal spell, but you'd much rather have it take one of your non-infect
creatures.
Maybe
he just couldn't find a spot in his deck at the point. Like, I mean, I'm not a fan of him cutting down on the amount of creatures he's playing, and Spellskite does just give him a creature that sort of...
I do see a lot of the unblockable effects going on in his main board. But I mean, think that's just the concession to the fact that he doesn't have
Gdaxian Probe. He needs more draw spells, basically. I don't think you want Twisted Image on Philip's side. Or too many ground spells, to be honest with you. Like, Twisted Image and Groundswell, the cards are most likely to side out this game.
Yeah.
And players look about ready. And yet again, it came down to whoever's on the play for this type of match. A lot of the time with racing matches, it's kind of hard if you're not on the play. Like, Burn has a bunch of Burn spells, but Darren unfortunately didn't have them that game.
Yeah. It's vital for Darren to come out of the gate swinging on this one. And should he win, he's going to really, really have to fight to break serve in game three, where he's going to be on the draw.
If he does win, we'll take a chance to look at standings and then talk about who could possibly make top 16, because he is in contention at this point. But definitely, he needs to win to make that dream stay alive. I see that hand and I say keep.
So what has he got in there? He's got Lightning Helix, Searing Blaze,
Swift Spear, Lightning Bolt, two lands.
And a Young Pyromancer.
And a Young Pyromancer.
Which is pretty good if you manage to keep those Blighted Agents off the board.
Yep. I mean, you're on the play, turn one, Swift Spear.
Definitely.
And
then depending on what Philip manages to cobble together.
If Philip doesn't go Gloss now off turn two, or Noble Hydrock,
I can get behind the Pyromancer.
Yeah. If Young Pyro sits, it's just going to be a massive race.
It's going to get out of hand really, really quickly.
And if he does, you can just Searing Blaze and hit him again. Philip's hand. Groundswell.
Definitely looks capable. He's got enough lands to deploy the Blighted Agent. I'm not sure how good that Groundswell's going to be after the fetches have been used up.
That's also another reason I'm not a fan of Groundswell post-board in this type of match. Most of the time it's just giving plus two, in which case Mutagenic Growth is a better card.
I'm actually surprised to see the amount of Blossoming Defense and Groundswell, because in my eyes they're kind of competing for similar slots.
Yeah, for me they don't nearly... they more or less replace each other.
Yeah.
And interesting to note, Philip is not playing any Mutagenic Growths in his 75.
I did not notice that. That is quite interesting.
And that's probably a concession to the number of aggro decks we have seen at Luxray's meta.
Well, you know, if you've got an issue with aggro decks, I can always suggest a lovely one mana card called Lightning Bolt.
It's a good point.
But maybe Philip's not in the market.
Rug Infect. Team of Battle Range. No, Assault Strobe would actually be a bit better.
Assault Strobe. Yeah. Now we're cooking.
Spicy Lightning Bolt on the sideboard, maybe mainboard too.
And if you see him later, you can board in your Monastery Swift Spears. Just go manual.
I mean, a lot of decks are playing Kitchen Finks in the sideboard anyway. So you could just become...
I'm sure Philip would have loved some Kitchen Finks in his sideboard for this matchup.
Yes. In fact, WMCQ, I did put a concession to four Kitchen Finks in my sideboard to deal with Naya Zoo, Naya Burn, any of those decks. I just didn't play against any of them at all.
I was about to ask, how many of those matchups did you encounter on the day?
A total of zero. Although I did kill people with Kitchen Finks Become Immense a couple of times.
They must have been quite impressed.
Well, no, they just ignore normal damage for some reason when you're playing Infect. I didn't watch the live total, then all of a sudden, Noble Hydrock, Kitchen Finks, Become Immense, take 10.
Okay, so we see Darren going upstairs with a Borderless Charm, getting a Plyo Sligo on his Swift Spear, and getting into the red zone.
And that is 6 damage total.
Not shabby for a turn 2.
And Philip's going to sack, get into 12. I mean, dealing 8 damage on turn 2 seems strong.
Maybe it's not such a bad thing that those Git Probes aren't in the deck anymore.
Well, Git Probe allowed a lot of on-the-play action.
Well, at this point, it'd just be free shocks for Darren.
Yeah. I mean, if worse came to worse, he could have played Git Probe with blue mana. And Philip has to shock here. That's not going to look healthy for him.
I see he's got 2 Glistener Owls.
He could deploy both. In fact, I'd probably deploy both. I don't see a point in deploying one and then holding up a protection spell here. The Sorcerer's swinging at you anyway.
Yeah, the Sorcerer's I don't see the Sophia being on blocking duty. It could be that Philip Slang to engineer play where Darien goes to burn the Alf, he protects it, and then it forces the Monastery Sophia not be able to swing.
Sure. Although I'd always attack first. I mean, even if the Sophia becomes an 0-1, if the Glistenalf dies, you don't have to care about it.
Okay, so he does go for the second Glistenalf.
And then we see a Tarkus command, not super relevant. Unfortunately, no landfall trigger this turn, so
yeah,
that's hitting
blades. Yeah, if Darien had drawn a land there, this could have been trouble for Philip.
Yeah. Let's take a look at his hand. Toxic Command, Lightning Helix, Lightning Bolt, and something else.
Okay, so Darien's going in for the attack.
Just seeing whether or not Philip's going to block.
Yes. Testing his might, as it were.
I mean, you could say that. I bet you ground swelling with pride after that joke.
I think we need to slow down on these, you know, before your head swells and becomes immense.
I mean, if you really want to command that, sure. Searing Blaze for one. Yeah.
I could see this as a fine opportunity to get it out of his hand.
Yeah, but it leaves himself dead.
He's just going to untap and, you know, kill Darien now.
I think he misses the land drop this turn.
Yeah, he definitely missed.
Which is fine. That means Darren's not dead yet. So Darien down to one infect point of damage.
And Darien not drawing lands really starting to punish him now. His hand's, you know, chock full of 2-mana spells and he's not able to deploy them efficiently. Also with Philip sitting on spell pierce,
yeah.
things are not looking great.
I'm telling you, I can think, can I die next turn? The answer is yes. Therefore, I would sit back because he has enough burn in hand to kill his opponent. So he could easily go.
I think he should be pumping the brakes. Although, if this pays off, which we know it won't.
Okay, attacks for two.
So very, very interesting line that Darien's going for here.
Well, if he doesn't die.
I think he's
die.
Just playing the, well, if I can't beat it, I got to try and beat him.
Yeah. I mean, I think Philip has another spell pierce in hand, which we see.
That is a beating.
And Philip, unfortunately, still no land.
And he top takes a Wild Defiance, which would have been fantastic right now. So Philip's currently on 5 life. It's quite possible that Darien can win this turn if he manages to get the right sequencing of his cards.
I mean, Philip's more than likely going to have to hold up blue in order to spell pierce this.
Yes, but if he chooses to attack, he'll leave himself open to just the Plough Sliggers and the Rift Bolt. And then Darien will have Bolt and whatever spells left in his
hand. So here for me, Darien kind of has to go Rift Bolt, targeting Glistenalf this next turn. And then Philip has to protect Glistenalf, and then you just target it again.
I actually prefer going upstairs with the...
Oh, sure. Put him,
with
and then
the
force Philip
him
to block.
To two, and then Philip's in the position of he has to tap out to try and win,
yeah.
And then you just, you know, go upstairs, and you still have the Swift Spear to attack for 2 damage, which is lethal, forcing the block. Mm.
Upkeep.
Okay.
We'll see where it goes.
Okay, so I'm not sure what the target was there.
Doesn't matter, he spell pierced immediately.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure it was Philip. I don't think he pointed at the Glistenalf.
Okay.
So he did take your line. I mean, yeah, if Darien Okay, well, he has to draw.
Oh, that is beautiful.
He draws untapped land.
Does Darren still have that lightning bolt, or did he use it already?
No, he used it. He tried to kill the Glistener off with it, and then he got spell pierced. Philip has to block you. 100% has to.
It's highly unlikely that Darren doesn't have a spell at this point.
Yes.
And Darren's perfectly fine with the -1/-1 counter being placed on his first spear, because he'll just be able to pump it into, being able to do damage again.
No effects. Move to damage.
Let's go, boys.
Lightning Helix.
This is beautiful.
And now the Swift Sphere doesn't even get a -1/-1 counter.
Yeah. Only way this could have been better for Darren is if that was a ride down.
I mean, if it was a ride down, I think we're playing the wrong format. To be honest with you.
Either way, we're winning, and that's...
That's a good point. That's a good point. Sacred Foundry tapped. Says a lot. Means he doesn't have a 1-mana spell. Philip's still not drawing a land, though. Well, I suppose neither has Darren.
Oh, well, you just got the second foundry. I mean...
And now a Wooded Foothill. This is just game. There's an Atarkus Command, and I think it's a Boros Charm?
Yeah, you can see he's picked up his pace now that he knows he's got the kill.
I mean, it was worrisome from both players.
Yeah, this is definitely a tight game.
It's probably one of the tighter ones we've had today. May as well shock there, I see. That actually could be a Young Pyro, in which case it's not very good.
Of course, yes, he still has the Young Pyro in hand. But I think you still, after being so aggressive, you can attack and
play the Pyro first, though. Attack. Woohoo. Philip must block, or you will lose outright.
Yes, but also if he blocks, how does he win?
That's a good point.
He's in a delicate situation of, sure, I'm on 5 and any spell kills me. And yes, my opponent laid on Pyromancer, which leads you to think they have a follow-up spell, but it's not impossible that that instead.
Okay, yeah, he had to just not block.
Yeah.
But...
He has to play for the win. He can't beat the spell.
Yep. In which case, though, you would have had to play for the win the last turn.
Yeah. Look, so, it's tough when, you're under the gun and you have to make these decisions.
If he was playing for the win, he should have done it last turn already. So there, because he was playing defensively anyway, there's no point not playing defensively.
Yeah, once you start blocking with Infect, it's not looking good for you. Especially against decks like Burn.
And that's why you have Kinshin Vinx in your sideboard. Sometimes. Okay, so now going to game 3. Philip had the Wild Defiance and the Spell Pierces there. Which were all looking good, except he couldn't cast Wild Defiance. I don't think he needs to bring anything else. Maybe a Necropede to have an additional creature, but Burn isn't really a deck where that's too important.
So, there is an opportunity here for Philip to get a bit tricksy. And I don't know if it's something that he's comfortable doing, but when... No, I suppose this line's just outrageous, considering he's on the play, but... The Nature's Claims, in conjunction with all the artifacts that are in his deck.
Nature's Claim your own artifacts. Yeah, that's
and gain the life. So you have the Necropede, it's still a threat.
If they kill it, you Nature's Claim in response.
Exactly. I'd suppose you haven't seen the Grim Lavamance out of Darren's deck, so maybe Pithing Needle could come in and do a similar type of trick.
The thing is, Philip isn't sure that Grim Lavamance is in Darren's deck.
Yes.
So, bringing in Pithing Needle, what do you name? You could name a Sackland.
You could name a Fetch. Yeah, no, I suppose that is a bit of a stretch. I'm just looking for options where...
I mean, Pithing Needle, when you had Detached Probe, you could get Probe then, see a bunch of the same Sackland and name it.
Yes.
Now, you're going in blind. Take a look at the hands.
Okay, but I suppose that's more of a on-the-play type of thought process that you go through as
so okay, Phillip's keeping his seven this time, I think. No, he's not. He has mauled every single game.
I think I actually heard the outcry of how ridiculous that hand was.
Yeah.
Has Darren also decided to mulligan?
Yep. Both players have decided to maul this game. I mean, Phillip can't afford to take this loss. Him losing will...
In terms of the overall...
Well, in terms of both the tournament standings today and the overall final standings, because he's the only unbeaten player at the moment. That's why he's playing against Darren, lost the last round. So even if he loses, there's still a chance he'll be first. Whereas Darren has to win, or else he is not making top 16.
I'm sure that... If one of the guys that he's beaten, if that's the only loss, that they'll jump above him in the final standings.
Depends on who it is. Like, if Naval wins out and Phillip loses and Darren wins, that's... And we see Phillip revealing his hand on camera to all of us to show how annoying it is for him. That he has to keep it. Well, okay, he's mulling.
That can't be a keep.
That's a mull.
Well, we need to get a judge over their stat.
He's mulling. They're both mulling to five.
Okay. This is dangerous territory here for both guys.
Well, for me.
And for us, having to commentate on...
Yeah, they're just not going to be friends with us afterwards.
Yeah.
I mean, if Phillip has to go to four, which is highly likely if he keeps no lands and no Gitax in terms of the deck.
Yeah.
Then...
I still like Infect on four cards.
Well, that's because it used to have Gitax in probe. Now you... just don't have anything. If you keep no lands.
I mean, what does Burn have? Okay, they could...
They could go land, Swift Spear, Bolt. Against Infect, that's perfect.
Fair enough.
It depends on the matchup. Like, if you need to outright burn your opponent to death, you can't go to 4. In a matchup where you're playing the control match, you're fine.
I'd much rather, you know, have to try and deal 10 damage than 20. Or
sure. Well, Darren's keeping this because he's scrying. Phillip's also scrying, so he's keeping that too. That becoming man's on Phillip's side, probably not going to stay there.
Okay.
He's staring at it hard, but I don't think it should stay there.
So Darren's going to be on the draw this game, which means he's going to get that lightning bolt, which I'm sure he's ecstatic about, because from what I can see, he doesn't have any kill spells in hand.
Yep. And Phillip's going to be leading with Noble Hydrock. Always a must kill.
Always?
A must kill. Like, okay, you could probably let Hydrock dissolve.
I mean, when your only kill spells are Lightning Bolt, and they just follow up with Lightning Edge after that. Is that where you want to be?
Not really, but they've mulled. I don't see Blighted Agent in Phillip's hand. I do see...
Oh, I was using it as an example of...
Sure.
You know, your hands are really so anemic, like. Well, we do get a free bolt here for Darren, which is always helpful.
I'm pretty sure I saw Inkmoth Nexus in Phillip's hand as his other creature.
Okay, so that's not a terrible.
And
start
Wild
for him,
Defiance.
Then.
Ooh, that's not really good.
Okay, so Darren deciding not to bolt the dork.
It's going to be annoying since Phillip's going to cast Wild Defiance this turn.
So Phillip's firmly ahead now. Yeah, this is. That's a beating.
Kind of need to kill that Hydrock before that dissolves. Or else you'll end up trying. Darren just needs to deed this again.
Yeah, he absolutely needs to get rid of that mana creature. In response to the Wilder fans.
Please kill it. Kill it now. Kill it with fire. You're not killing that Inkmoth Nexus.
Yeah, you need to... Your only option is to now limit him on mana. So that he can't go absolutely crazy.
I mean, Inkmoth is only going to deal one a turn, which is 10 turn clock. Yeah. You just have to hope Phillip doesn't
does
top
Phillip
thing.
Have another land in hand?
Yes.
But he doesn't have any palm spells.
No.
That
just
is like a spell pierce.
Yeah, it's spell pierce.
Okay, there we go.
There's a path to exile. It's not going to matter too much.
Okay, so doesn't look like Darren got a land.
And Philip top decks becoming mints.
Was it becoming mints? No, yes. He top decked the land. He had the becoming mints.
No.
Was it the other way around?
Yeah, he had the land and the spell pierce to top deck becoming mints.
Well, it's not quite live yet, considering the amount of money he has to spend to just animate the land.
Yeah. But he could, like, spell pierce. I mean, he could be living dangerous if he uses the spell pierce just to get it into his graveyard.
I think it's a fine just to attack for 1 year. Pass yeah. Turn, spell pierce the Rift Vault, just to feel the delve.
The problem is, losing the spell pierce means it's opening up the path, which Darren drew.
Fair enough, but it's not like he has the mana to be able to protect his creature and cast the pump spell.
Yeah.
Plus, Darren's highly incentivized to keep doing things.
Yep. Well, Darren's on 17, let's update that. Not that it matters too much. And the Rift Vault didn't resolve, so...
Okay, so drawing the land might actually... Oh, just passing? Instant speed spells are fantastic. They allow you to do things like this.
Yeah. I mean, you don't really want to hit anything in Philip's deck right now. Philip got 13.
I'm sure he'll be getting himself another bleeding pool here. Well, this is shaping up to be quite an interesting game. Both players, you know, having to walk a fine line of, you know, how much they can commit, how much they need to hold back.
I mean, if Philip untaps and throws a bomb spell, I think he just did, might as well closer. He might just go for lethal here and then get blown out for Dan's path.
Yeah, if he doesn't leave the spell scenario up, he can't go for lethal.
Yeah.
This is where mutagenic growth would come in, which is a fantastic pairing with Wild Defiance.
Darren's like, yeah, I'm just going to take one. It's fine.
Yeah, Darren's fine just sitting, waiting until, you know, he can develop his mana a bit better.
No blocks declared.
If Darren has multiple removal spells...
Multiple paths is
sure,
what he
needs.
Sure,
has to be very specific removal spells. But if he... So he more than likely would have brought in the deflecting palms.
Yep.
Maybe he can kind of set up a scenario where...
He goes path deflecting palm, kill exactly. Philip. Yeah, I was thinking the same thing, except he was like really tight in mana at that point.
Yeah. I mean, look, he's got, what, at least 7 turns?
Yep.
Before,
I mean, this is like end of turn Boros job.
Of course, he still gets to, well, attack Philip, as
yeah.
It were.
At instant speed on top of it. And what did he draw? He drew another path.
Fantastic.
But unfortunately, well, he has deflecting form in hand. Unfortunately for Darren, doesn't have double white.
Well, I think over the course of 2 turns, because of Philip's mana situation, I think it's fine where he can, after combat, plant path, untap. You know, go for the second one. And then just hope that there are no more infectors out of Philip's deck or off the top.
And Philip has a choice here. He really, really wants to go for lethal this turn. You can see it. I mean, he can't play this hierarchy. He simply just can't.
If he plays the hierarchy, he can't attack.
Yeah.
And I think that's.
So we're gonna see Dan and just take it, hopefully, and like sequence it correctly. Yeah, okay. It's happened, Philip. You can't not do it. Okay.
You can see Philip going through all the potential lines, you know, what might, you know, go down.
I mean, well, you must be thinking like it's path, maybe deflecting bomb, maybe path and deflecting.
So those are all the thoughts that are going through your head, but it could just be double bolt at you, untap, bolt you again.
Yeah.
You know, fortunately for Darren, a lot of the deck is, or a lot of his spells are instants, so he gets to play this pseudo-control game.
I mean, that's why I don't like Wild McCartle in Burn, because it doesn't have haste.
Exactly.
It's not an instant.
I I'm sure Philip is kicking himself for Gitaxian Probe right now.
Yep. If he had Gitaxian Probe, then he would know exactly what he needs to do.
This is exactly what Wizards, you know, wanted to happen.
I mean, I can get behind this. I'm not like the biggest fan when it comes to Infect.
Although, on this turn, Philip would have to play Life for it, and he'd be putting himself in very close range to just dying as well.
Hydrock.
Okay.
No attacks.
Wise.
Hit you for 3.
So what do you think of Philip using a Spell Pierce here? Do you think that's just...
I think he'd kill himself. He just there's no point. It's not lethal. Data needs to top deck exactly land, which he doesn't.
Okay. So just that one mana creature has now put Philip slightly ahead just because of the amount of mana he has.
I think Philip wins here, to be honest with you. But he needs to sequence it correctly. Become immense. I mean,
is this lethal?
Closer. This is exactly 8.
Oh, because of the Wild Defiance, yes. Of course. It's been there so long that I totally forgot I was on the battlefield.
I mean, that Spell Pierce, real card. Spell Pierce.
There we go.
GG's. I mean, they had to play it out pretty conservatively. If Philip had been a bit more aggressive, he'd have just lost.
It was just really unfortunate for Darren that, you know, he didn't get a third land, which would have allowed him to...
I mean, if his next card was land, preferably, like, white source land.
Well, any fetch land.
Actually, like, if he had fetched Sacred Foundry instead of Stomping Ground, he would have won as well.
Yes.
But you can't say that in hindsight.
Yeah, well, he wanted the green source so that he could fire off the Tarkus Command.
Yeah.
And, you know, these burn decks aren't playing Temple Garden, which would have allowed him to hold up Double Path, but, you know...
His deck could afford Temple Garden,
they don't cast Lightning Bolt, which is just not what the deck's looking for.
I mean, that was so close, it was just...
Yeah, the top-taking of that Noble Hierarch really... It's like an unassuming draw.
I mean...
But when you realize how tight each play is on mana... And what it actually enables you to do.
If Darren had just top decked the land, White Source specifically, would have been fine. Like, or had he put Philip under more pressure to force Philip to Spell Pierce?
I hope they keep showing us what they've decided to bring in. Yeah, I want to see how many smash effects that, you know, Darren decided to bring in. Because a destructive rivalry would have been fantastic.
Yeah.
At some point, like in an end step, you know, go for the smash. And then hold the path up for whatever else is left.
Against Infect, like, when I'm on the draw, I do bring in the Destructive Revelry.
Oh, yeah. Like,
because Spellskite, Wild Defiance,
yeah,
Inkmoth Nexus, I mean, it hits a lot.
And the things that it hits are, like...
All good against Burn. Really, really good.
They're heavily impactful.
Okay. Well, we'll transition back to see what they sided in, and they will discuss it for you.
Okay. So, did he bring in that Necropede?
Yes. And 2 Wild Defiance and 2 Spell Pierce.
Spell Pierce.
I mean, Dan probably should have brought in more Deflecting Bombs. I always bring in more. So he probably did.
Looks like he's still going.
Sure.
Okay, so no smash effects from the burn deck.
On the draw, I think you kind of need them.
Oh, definitely. You're definitely the... You're trying to steal tempo, you're trying to break serve, and you need the tools to do that.
And like those helixes he had, bad. Tarkus Command, bad. Tarkus Command made him lose because made him fetch the wrong mana.
Well, indirectly.
Well, it's as indirectly as, like, he could have just sided them out, which we were discussing before.
Yeah.
2 mana, deal 3 damage. Not amazing on the draw.
It's not good, Lates. I would definitely preferred to see a Destructive Revelry in the slot, but then for that same argument you made.
But okay, if he had Destructive Revelry in that slot, it doesn't cost him because Wild Defiance disappears. and then he can
bolt. Well, not even Wild Defiance. You could just take out the infect land end of turn, leave Philip on no clock, and then just go willy-nilly until you see the next threat.
Yep. Like, I mean, he had the path, but he couldn't cast it. He could cast it, but he was running out of spell pierce. There's a lot of things that could have happened. And that was it for the last round. We'll have standings in a bit. But before that, we'd like to discuss the Dragon Shield sleeves that we got in. We have new colors, I believe. Crimson, classic. It's not the matte ones. Copper, fusion, matte ivory, and purple.
Those are my personal favorites.
Yeah, I think the matte ivory looks amazing. I'm not going to lie. It's probably one of my favorites. I would probably buy a set myself.
Yeah, I bought a set this morning, not regretting it, just put on my standard deck.
Yeah, I mean, like, it looks great. It's not opaque, see-through. It's just really good. Quality is great, Dragon Shield as well. I prefer them over, like, KMCs. KMCs tend to tear every once in a while. Can't really double sleeve KMCs
either. KMCs are good too. It's just it depends on how you shuffle.
Yeah.
I mean,
a lot of people mash shuffle though.
So I'm ripping sleeves left and center. But the Dragon Shields have been pretty good, and they're decent if you decide to get the inner sleeves as well.
Yeah.
They fit with the KMC inner sleeves. You just have to make sure that when you put the card in, it slides in all the way.
But yeah, that was it for round 5. We'll see you guys next month with the finals of the Modern 2K series. Actually, just to go through who definitely made it, we'll switch to the sheet. Basically, everyone you see up until Edward Bell, basically, made it in the top 16. They're definitely qualified.
And then we just
and then the 16th
the
place is basically going to depend on whether or not Danon has a higher score than JP.
Yes, because they should both be taking... They'll both be moving past Morgan.
Yeah.
Who unfortunately wasn't able to play today. That'll be our 16th slot.
Yeah, and also, it's also going to come down to the total average finish. So, if they are on the same points, which is the only way Danon can get in because of his loss, then basically... It's going to come down to the average standing between JP and Danon. And yep, that's it from us. See you guys next month.